Hello students, welcome back. I hope you enjoyed my last video. I'm here to share with you certain kind of sentences, sentence structures which are a bit difficult, and most of the students face problems when they come across these kind of sentences. There are different ways of doing a work. The very first one is when we do the work by ourselves, and sometimes we don't do the work by ourselves, we get the work done. So we get the work done with the help of, we make a payment to the person and the person does work for us, and sometimes we don't pay but we get his consent to do the work. And another one is there, when we force a person, we compel a person to do something. So first of all, I would like to discuss the sentence which we do ourselves, and I think it is quite simple, and I don't think that you would face any problem. The one is, I polished my shoes, means this is the work which I did myself. I polished my shoes. But the second one, I would like to discuss this one. This one is a bit difficult and most of the students face problem. The sentence is, I got my shoes polished. Here, I didn't polish my shoes. I got my shoes polished from someone. मैंने अपने जूते किसी से पॉलिश करवाए हैं, ना कि खुद किए हैं. So what would be the structure of this one? So I got my shoes polished. I is a subject. Got is a verb, main verb. Shoes, here we would put a noun or pronoun. Shoes are noun. Then we would use past participle or the third form of the verb, and all the sentences would be formed in the same way. I would like to give you some more example of this one. Just a minute. Like, he got his hair cut. He got his hair cut. It means he didn't cut his hair, he got his hair cut from somebody else, like the barber or somebody else. So sentence structure is the same. He is a subject, got is there, then noun, my hair is a noun, and cut is the third form of cut, because first, second and third form of cut is the same. So we can form more sentences. It will always be there. Third form will always be there. It will not change. Yes, it can change. If you want to write it in present tense, then we can say, she gets her shoes polished. She gets her shoes polished. It can, the main verb will get changed, will change according to the tense. So let's move on to the next one, the third one. When we get our work done, but without any payment or without consent, we force the person, we compel the person to do the thing. The person is not interested in doing so. Like, I made him polish my shoes. What does it mean? He didn't want to polish my shoes. I compelled him, I forced him to polish my shoes. And it is by force. Like, I made him stand in the sun. I made him stand in the sun. is, it means she forced me, she compelled me to wash the dishes. And the sentence structure would be the same. First, subject, then maid, then noun or pronoun, and this is the object. Similarly, this is the subject, maid, then noun or pronoun, then first form of the verb. First form of the verb, stand in the sun. It will always be the first form. And I want you to make some more sentences of the same kind. And if you face any problem, you can comment below and I will get back to you. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and also subscribe my channel if you like this. Thank you very much.